Hello and welcome back to Excelsif. In my last video, I had shown you how to create 2D barcodes and QR codes in Excel. Today, I'm going to show you how you can print them in bulk using Mail Merge. If you want to check out the most comprehensive tutorial about Mail Merge, you can check this video. Link will be in the description and on the top right. So, you have generated two types of barcodes and you wish to print them. Maybe to a normal paper and then cut them individually, or maybe you wish to print them on label sheets. You know the ones which are like a sticker and you just peel a label out of the sheet? I have a blank Word file opened here, and first we are going to start with Mail Merge. Go to the Mailings tab up top, Start Mail Merge, Labels. First option is the printer you have. If you have one of those printers where you put a paper roll instead of A4 sheets, choose this one. But for the most of us, I guess we are going with the second option, page printers. In this drop-down, we got the label vendors. These labels come pre-packaged with the product name, which tells you how many labels are in one A4 sheet. I'm going to choose Microsoft and then this option, 30 per page. By the way, if you need to verify your label size, you can click on Details. Or if you have something that is not in this list, create a new one by going in New Label. We have everything we need, so click on OK. And we have a table with the labels marked. Each of this cell is a label. Now we move to select our data. Go to Select Recipients, Use an existing list, and we are going to select the Excel file we created with our product codes. It shows us two sheets. We are starting with the first one, which had our product codes and 2D barcodes that we created in the last video. We are going to write a command here which can single-handedly create all these types of barcodes. To start with this command, press Ctrl F9 and you will see two curly brackets come up. You have to use Ctrl F9, typing the curly brackets just won't work. We have to write a command in between these. So let's begin with an example so I can give you a basic idea about how it works. We start with display barcode, space, then the data we need to convert in barcode in double quotes. So for this example, let's say we want to create a barcode for 1, 2, 3. So we put that in double quotes. Then comes the type of barcode. Let's go for code 128 this time. We have to mention that without any spaces. Then a space, backslash T, space again, backslash H, space 1000 and done. Let me give you an idea what all this means. First bit is clear. We want to display barcodes. Second bit is the data you want to be converted into barcodes. Then comes the type of barcode. And you have all these options to choose from. If you want to create any other type of barcode, like maybe code 39 or EAN13, and then comes switches, which are optional and are applied after a backslash. Like T is the switch if you wish to see the text with the barcode, which is beneficial as it gives you the idea of which product code is converted to barcode. And lastly, H is for the height of the barcode. There are many switches available. You can even change the foreground color and background color as well with the help of switches. You can find the link of the Microsoft page which explains all this in detail in the description. Moving on. Now since our command is complete, right-click on it and choose Toggle Field Code and voila, here is our barcode. See how easy that was? But that's only half the job done. This is just the dummy data. We have to replace it with our product codes from the Excel file. So right-click on it again and choose Toggle Field Codes again. Now select this bit in double quotes. We need to change it, and while you have it selected, go up to Insert Merged Fields and select Product Code and done. Now this barcode matches our product code from our Excel file. It looks a bit small, so let's change the height switch and increase its value a little. So right click, toggle field codes and change this 1000 to 1200 and toggle field codes again. A little better now. Let's put them all in center, so click this icon here to select them all and go to Layout on top, and under Alignment, choose this option to bring all of them in the center. But all the rest of our labels are still not showing any barcodes. Let's fix that. go back to the Mailings tab and click on Update Labels in Write and Insert Fields group. Don't worry about the next record bit, it won't be printed. If you click on Preview Results, you can verify that. Your whole sheet is ready. You can print it from here on the labels or as a PDF to print it later. You can use the same command to create QR codes as well. Let's quickly do that too. I have another Word file here because we have to link the second sheet this time, which had our data for QR codes. So let's go to Start Mail Merge, Labels, and since QR codes are bigger than the 2D barcodes we did earlier, this time we are going to choose 3M. You can choose any other one as per your choice. This is only for this example as I needed some template with bigger label sizes. Under here, let's choose 3M21310. It has 10 labels per sheet, which should be enough. Next up, select recipients, use an existing list and select the file, but this time choose sheet 2. Let's write a command again. Press Ctrl F9. Display barcode, then space, QR, space again, backslash Q. This Q is required when you are creating QR codes as this mentions the error correction. If you recall, we had the same option in the add-in we installed in our previous video. Same thing here, we have to mention values between 0 and 3. Let's mention 2 here. Now scroll back to before QR and put your cursor there. Here we are going to put our merged field. So click on Insert Merged Field and choose Link, as that is the field with all our links, phone number, addresses, etc. So go to Insert Merged Field and choose Link and done. Let's click on Update Labels, make them all in center like the last time and Preview Results. Here we have all the QR codes. Don't be alarmed with the last two results where it says data length is not supported by current type. That's because we only had 8 cells with data which have already been used to generate QR codes, and these two are extra. The only drawback I could find with creating QR codes like this is I can't seem to control the size and mention text beneath them. I understand mentioning internet links might not be a good idea considering sometimes they can be a bit long, but mentioning name and phone number would have been nice. But maybe if you play around with this, you might be able to do it. If you do, let me know in the comments. In any case, if you don't like this command to create QR codes, you can always use the add-in we added last time. Remember, it works for Word and PowerPoint too. You just have to go to Home tab and click on Add-ins and here it is. That concludes this video and my two-part series about creating and printing barcodes. You don't need any fancy software to do this. You can just do it in our very own MS Office. Hope you liked this video and learned something new and useful. Leave a like, share and comment after you've subscribed, of course. I'll see you in the next one with another video, maybe simplifying a complex formula in Excel or maybe solving an issue you have in your Excel journey. Until then, happy spreadsheeting.